Welcome to Do It Yourself E-Liquid Recipes. I'm John, I'm a flavor compounder, and today I'm back with 5 more common mistakes to avoid in your DIY mixing. For the second part in this series, I will start with number 1, which is too much vegetable glycerin. This is something I see very often. A lot of people, for their own personal reasons, are afraid of propylene glycol and get into Do It Yourself so they can make 80% or 90% vegetable glycerin e-liquids. Now, I don't say vaping 100% vegetable glycerin is bad, but there is a reason that there is propylene glycol in most e-liquids. Companies know that they could take advantage of the vegetable glycerin craze, but the problem with high VG juice is that the flavor is much harder to blend in the mix, and also it needs much higher temperature to be vaped properly. So the last thing these companies want to do is have to use 15 or 20% of flavorings and also have a chance of receiving a reputation that their juices break coils. Now to add very quickly to this, I'll say that in the beginning of vaping, most e-juice was 80% or sometimes even 95% propylene glycol. So to me that we have come all the way to 70 or 80% vegetable glycerin recipes is a very big improvement. If for your personal preference you want to vape max VG juice, I don't say don't do it, but prepare to have the right atomizer that can handle the extra vegetable glycerin thickness, and don't find it strange that if some VG based flavorings might need to be mixed as high as 15 or 25% in your recipes. Next, number 2 is steeping will fix any juice. Now this is not very common, but there are still few people that believe in this myth. Well, truth is, I'll just say this applies 98% of the time, but if you mixed up a recipe and it sucks, even if you would put it to steep in Swarovski bottles for a year, most likely the juice will come out tasting the same as the time it was made. There are a few exceptions to this, like very thick creams or floral and bold tobaccos, but even then, if the ratios are not right in the first place, there is no amount of steeping that could fix the flavor. Give a bad mix a week of steeping, and if it still tastes bad, then it's time to clean the bottle and move on. Next, number 3 is not exploring new flavors. This is something most of us do, including myself. I know it seems like a waste of money to buy a flavor that you won't like as a food flavor. For example, a lot of people might not like peanut butter, so they wouldn't consider vaping it. What I have found personally is that a lot of flavors that I would usually think I wouldn't like, actually when you vape them are pretty decent. So I'll give you my way to discover new flavors. I don't look for recipes to make, but instead I look for specials or sales on commercial e-juice. I do this because I believe if someone was confident enough to bottle and sell this recipe, then it's most likely at least decent. This method doesn't work all the time 100%, but it's better than buying random flavor concentrates that I might never use more than one time. Number 4 for today is about nicotine, and this is making low nicotine recipes using high amount of nicotine. In general, as a high amount of nicotine, I would consider anything at 12 milligrams or above. At this level, we are already talking about 1/8 or 12% of the whole e-juice is just a nicotine solution. This way, you could never get the same full flavor from a recipe designed for 3 or even 6 milligrams of nicotine while using twice as much of it, since it dilutes the flavoring too much. What I would recommend if you like vaping high amounts of nicotine is to find commercial e-liquids for sale that are popular and available at high nicotine. That will give you an idea of the type of profiles that you can work with, since not every flavor tastes well with high amounts of nicotine. For example, any cookie or cheesecake flavor starts to become bitter at 10 milligrams of nicotine or more, but fruits like apple or peach flavors, for example, can blend well and hide the aftertaste of nicotine better. Also, some rums and dark tobacco, especially Hangshan tobaccos, can work very well with high amounts of nicotine. And the last one is about nicotine again, and it is not taking nicotine seriously. While this might sound like a public service announcement, but the amount of nicotine that is needed to be fatal for a person is very small. First, the general belief was that the lethal dose for an adult is about 75 milligrams. This claim was challenged in 2003 again due to the popularity of vaping rising and a new study discovered that about 500 milligrams is actually needed for a lethal dose in an adult. But they also found in the same study that for children that have never been exposed to the substance before, a dose of even 10 milligrams could be fatal. So wear gloves when you can, wash your hands, and try to keep concentrated nicotine somewhere hidden if you have small children around. And with this last one, I come to the end of this list again. Hopefully this video again gave you some helpful information. Leave me a comment with your experience if you'd like. As always, thank you for your time, and I'll see you next time.